1970, 25th December 1970 is the day that this journey began. This journey which began in Kolkata, the journey that I am about to share with you today. Born to parents who were dancers, who were practitioners and performers, not only in the style of creative dance, but also taught dancing at an academic institute like Loreto House, dancing was a way of life for me. But it's not just about dancing being a way of life. Academics was also a very important part of my life as well, because I grew up in a joint family. A joint family where my grandfather was a physicist, where my aunts were scientists, one was a geologist, the other a virologist. So during my growing up years, both my cousin, my younger brother, for all of us, performing arts, be it dance, music, was always a very important part of life and an equally important part of life along with academics. I trained in different kind of styles. So for 20 years, I learned Uday Shankar style of dance under my parents, Sri Shanti Bose and Sunanda Bose. I also trained for 8 years in Bharatanatyam under Guru Thankamani Kutty, and then for 16 years in Odissi under Guru Giridhari Nair for 10 years, 6 years under Sanjukta Panigrahi, and finally also workshops by Guru Kelicharan Mahapatra. But apart from this life in dance, what was most exciting about was that even in school, we got to learn Indian dance. Indian dance was a compulsory subject that we had to pursue from class 1 to class 8. It was held twice a week, and I looked forward to these classes because it not only meant that I got to meet my parents twice a week in school, but it also meant that I could do what I did enjoy the most, which was dance. And for my classmates, it meant that those who enjoyed dancing did not just have to pursue dancing during weekend classes, but could do it in school as well. Now, as I grew up, I realized that dance was not only something that gave me tremendous joy because it was my passion, but it helped me become the person I am today. And what I am today? What am I today? I play multiple roles in fact. So I not only teach and in charge of performing arts as well as international relations at Symbiosis School for Liberal Arts, international relations being a subject that I pursued from Jadavpur University and then qualified in for my UGC net for lectureship in colleges and universities. So as you can see, both played a very important role in my life. Now, it's important to have performing arts in our life. Why is it important? Is performing arts just a subject that we need to study? Or does it play a role in society as well? Does it play a role in our lives? Now, if you look at classical forms, classical dance, for example, tells stories. What are these stories that they tell? They tell stories of gods, goddesses. They tell stories of myths, mythologies. They bring the shlokas and the stotras, which are the domain of the Vedas, the Puranas, which were the realm of knowledge which was contained within the Brahmins to the common man. If you look at the folk form, how does the folk form help us? The folk form is a celebration of life. Be it a birth, be it a marriage, be it a religious festival, folk forms unite the community, brings out everyone together. And then finally, there's the creative form. The creative form which tells the story of the common man. So therefore, we find that it plays a very important role in terms of building the community together, bringing the community together. Also, dance, music, theater, or any other performing arts need not be looked at just as a separate subject. It could be a perspective as well. And what is this perspective that we're talking about? I'm sure when you study history and you study the freedom movement of India, what if we studied this through the patriotic songs that were developed during the entire freedom struggle, and we studied the reasons why they came about? We will be studying Indian history from a very unique perspective. If I'm going to be talking about the Vietnam War, why just talk about the Vietnam War? Why not start off with Paul Hardcastle's song 19, and where you get to know that the average age of the soldier who fought and died in the Vietnam War was 19. So why not start off with what was so important about the Vietnam War, that such young people, young members of the community needed to give up their life for? So, when we look at performing arts, what I've shared with you, it plays a tremendous role. But yet, what is surprising is that it is not there in the syllabus of any of the national boards in our country. CBSE, ICSE do not have performing arts in their syllabus. ISC has it, but only as a paper in music in the senior school level. And CBSE also has performing arts, but only focuses on the classical form, and that too in the 11 and 12. So that's a high school level. But at the same time, why should dance be subject that is something extracurricular? Why should our passion have to wait for weekend classes? Why can't it be a part of our lives? Why can't we grow up with what we love doing as well as studying? So, if we look at performing arts, because performing arts is needed not just because of the role it plays in society, but the kind of friendships that we develop, because the hours that we spend rehearsing together. It is important in team building, because it's not just about yourself who's going to go out and perform, it's about the entire team who goes out and performs. It's about the entire program which is being put together. And during that, we build a friendship and camaraderie that stays with you for life. Also, if you look at the confidence level, so I had a student, for example, who would not walk properly and used to wear foot pads as a child. And then she joined my class as a student to learn dancing. A few months later, her parents sent me a letter on Teacher's Day saying that dance had completely changed her personality. She was now much more extrovert in nature. She went up to people. She used dance as a conversation opener to communicate and build up friendships. If you also see, it builds up a lot of self-esteem, therefore. The fear of the stage is not there. You can just go up to stage and speak and talk to an audience. Also, it develops a certain amount of understanding and trust. How? Because when you're performing a group item, you need to feel what the other person is doing in order to ensure synchronization. You know what? Because on stage, you cannot look at each other. So you need to feel. So that level of understanding has to be there. Also, it teaches you tremendous humility. How and why? Because the more you learn, the more you realize how little you know. And that makes you a very humble person. But please remember that this humility that is developed should not be mistaken as a person's weakness. It is, in fact, that person's strongest point. And as you learn, you realize and you respect your guru or the teacher who's taking you in that path and guiding you. It's not something that needs to be imposed from above, that you need to respect your teacher. It's not that. It's just about the respect that automatically comes through when you are looking at your learning. Also, it's a great stress buster. Why is it a great stress buster? Because you're not competing with anyone. You're just doing what you love doing. And who is the only competition? Yourself. You're trying to better yourself. And also, all the growing years when you feel the world doesn't understand you and you're so angry with everyone else, it is one of the best constructive ways to let go of all those confused emotions. And therefore, why should performing arts not be a part of the curriculum when it plays such an important role? Also, if you look at politics across the globe today, since I teach international relations, I need to talk about it as well. It is politics of xenophobia. What does xenophobia mean? Fear of people who are not the same. When does xenophobia appear? Only when you don't understand other people. Only when you don't understand other cultures. Now suppose each curriculum, each board across all countries have performing arts as part of the curriculum. And then cultural exchanges took place between the students. You would understand what other cultures, what other people were about. So this politics of hate, this divisiveness which is there in society, tolerance, acceptance of other cultures would also become a part of our life. Okay? So the thing is that I play multiple roles, and I'm sure all of us play multiple roles. I'm a mother, a daughter, a wife, a teacher, a researcher, a daughter-in-law, but none of this would have been possible without the family support that we receive. Especially the support and understanding from my husband and my daughter's understanding also, which lets me be the person I am. And therefore, the question that arises is, what now? Well, now is the time that it's, and it's high time in fact, that we need to incorporate performing arts into the curriculum. Why? Because there's art and creativity within all of us. So why should we not become complete individuals through the education system? And therefore, even if that does not happen immediately, I look forward to you. Because you, in a few years' time, you will be the doers. You will be the enablers. You will be the influencers. And therefore, if I may borrow from our Cognoscente, I would like to end with a few lines from his poem, The Ode. We are the music makers. We are the dreamers of dreams. But we look forward to you. So great hail we cry to the comers from the dazzling unknown shores. Bring us hither your sun and your summers and renew our world as of yore. You shall teach us your song's new numbers and things that we dreamed not before. Thank you.